Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video guys to any of you having a car and your alternator quit charging. Stay with us, we'll explain the number one and two reasons why alternator doesn't work and how you can easily rebuild it and fix it guys for just a few bucks instead of buying a new alternator. All that will be covered in this video. Before we start guys, let me introduce you to the channel. Every single car we get at the garage, we take them completely apart, as you can see, engines, transmission, anything guys, and we show you how to fix pretty much anything and make at least 200 to 300 videos on every single car we get at the garage. Why we do that? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need guys in return, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, that way we can keep providing this free information to you. Now, if you guys need to buy any parts, tools, parts that we'll be using here, check out the link in the description of the video below. That's where we get all our supplies and parts from. Before we start, let me guys, tell you here. If you guys want to learn more about diagnostics, fixing your vehicles, electrical components, things like that, check out our second YouTube channel, Electrical Car Repair Life. You can find information that can save you thousands of dollars, and we have helped more than 20 million people so far. So, now, let's explain guys what can cause that. Number one, make sure the serpentine belt didn't fall off or didn't break, because if that happens, nothing will turn the alternator and it will not charge. But we assume that the belt is good, everything's good, everything is running fine, but the alternator is not charging. What can guys cause that? Let's explain now. While you have the alternator removed, always inspect the bearings, spin it and see if it turns nicely, guys. Usually on the alternator, you have two wires. One is with a nut, that's where the battery charging wire connects, and one is a signal wire with a clip. And on the back side, you have a cover. If you remove that cover, usually it has two or three bolts, nuts. It really depends on the design. Okay, you can lift it up, and once it comes out, okay, let's explain what you have here, guys. Almost there. Okay. This right here, guys, is your alternator. This is the diode pack. This is what transforms the AC, the alternating current to direct current, AC to DC. And if one of those diodes dies, okay, what will happen? Okay, first, the alternator may quit working. Second, it can actually let AC current in the system, which is alternating current, and that can cause damage to the electronics of your vehicle, guys. That can cause, quite a bit of damage, and in some cases, you may not suspect even anything. But when you turn your car off, you will have a battery drain that will kill the battery, because the diode will let the current go back to the alternator and will kill your battery. This right here guys, it's your voltage regulator and brush pack. Now, the voltage regulator is very important. If it quits, everything quits. Brush pack, super important, because if the brushes are worn out, there is nothing to actually sense the signal, to hear, and as a result, it will not work. So the brushes, you can see them, how they contact the alternator. Now, in most cases, the brush pack and the voltage regulator come in one package. In some cases, it could be two separate things. And if there are two separate things, inspect the brushes. If they're still good, you may have a bad regulator, guys. Those are the top two things that go bad on an alternator. Of course, you may have internal issue as well. That could happen. But number one, guys, wore out brushes. Number two, bad voltage regulator. And you can see how you can simply remove it just like that. And by removing the cap, you can actually easily install them later as well. Okay, you just get them here in the canals, you install them, and you guys, just install the bolts and you're ready to go. But those are the number one and two things that will go bad. If you want to buy a new brush pack or voltage regulator, I'll put the link in the description of the video below. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.